Hello, in this video we're going to learn how to use the standard deviation formula to calculate the standard deviation of a sample set. The samples that we're going to use are 2, 4, 4, 6 and 9. All of these values can be considered x in my calculation. So what we do is we draw a little table filling in 2, 4, 4, 6 and 9. We would square these numbers under a column headed x squared, so 4, 16, 16, 36, and 81. And the little squiggles which you see, which look a little bit like backward threes in the formula, are in fact the Greek letter sigma, and they mean sum up or total, so here and here. So this means that we need to take the total, which in this case is going to be 25, and again we total up the x squareds, which is going to give us 153. This is going to be the total of x, so therefore sigma x and sigma x squared respectively. Simply substituting in the values which we have, n by the way is the number of items in my data set. So that's going to be the square root of 153 minus 25 squared all over the 5 items which I have, and that's going to be over the 5 items which I have minus 1. The reason it's minus 1 is we're working out the average gap size. Scroll my board down a little. And this is going to give me S, the first thing we work out is the 25 squared, so that's going to be 153 minus 625 over 5, all over 4, and we're going to take the square root of the whole lot. Importantly, make sure that you bring your square root symbol beneath the level of your fraction line. This will indicate that you're actually taking the square root of the bottom as well. It will cost you marks if you don't. So, S is going to be 153 minus 125 over 4, having worked out the 625 over 5. And again, we take the square root of the whole lot. So S is going to equal 28 over 4. Again, taking the square root of all, giving you a final answer of S equals root 7. It's quite common that the SQA will ask you to provide the answer as a decimal, or will indeed ask you to give it to a number of significant figures. When you put that into your calculator, that's going to give you 2.646. 3 marks for final answer. For substituting values and forgetting to that stage. Thanks for watching.